Met everybody, all our friends and swear us as friends. The inaugural and all that is over, I was slightly delayed. I couldn't be present at the right time. Anyway, I understand that 3 hours of good deliberations, discussion would have happened and the participants would have, all of you would have benefited on internet security and the threat perceptions, national and international level. All those things would have spoken out by now. I just want to give my perception, because I have been trying to do this e-governance for the last many years. 2005 onwards, 5, 6, I was like secretary here, then I was the government of India, where I introduced a good system in the intellectual property office, where security was a very, very big issue. Then back to the state government, again I got in charge of this. We have gone so much ahead in e-governance, and coupled with after the new government came, the Jan Dhan Yojana, the direct benefit transfers and all that came. Now citizens in large numbers are linked to almost all the government programs, get linked into this. Payments worth thousands of crores moves through internet systems, banking systems to individuals. There could be a lot of security issues, there could be fraud. And companies as well, they do all this now in the internet route. So the security, of course, there's no need to emphasize the need to be very, very cautious about security aspects. Now the international threat perception wise, with so many terrorist organizations are trying to attack countries, not directly, not physically, through an undeclared cyber war, might create future more and more problems, especially when it comes to the governmental system. It is much more important. The other one only have a financial aspect if the company is affected. But attacking a country's system would actually weaken the country. The governance will get affected, and the country as a whole get affected. Country's image in international will get affected. This would happen to states. For example, we have a few hackings of our websites which were not secured. The moment such a thing happens, it becomes a huge news. It has happened 2 months back in Kerala, some 12-13 websites were hacked. And I get calls from a number of press people saying that the US is all gone. And you know, it's a big email issue, comes for us 1 or 2 days. It took around 7-8 hours to get it back and tell the press that everything is all right. But within that time, the image of the government actually scoops down so fast, saying that you are not cautious. And those are happened basically because the governmental departments are not bothered about security, they are bothered about the money that they have. They make cheap software, or let's go when they post it elsewhere without security, nobody knows. And this is happening. So that is one example. I think in the last 4 or 5 years I faced many times, and that lowers our image very much. And I have to do this. So issues like that starts. As far as Kerala is concerned, we are very cautious about this, except those things our SDCs are well protected today situation. We have taken all questions regarding all that. But we are increasingly into more of e-governance. Our 70-80% of the departments have introduced e-governance in varying degrees. Some departments have gone much more, but otherwise they have lesser. Kerala is nationally one of the high level of e-governance implemented state. We have been doing from the beginning onwards. But all these are, the security is always a concern. We have gone to a level where we have almost Digital India visualized things, minus manufacturing, and those things have happened in Kerala in terms of connectivity, in terms of our telecom infrastructure, in terms of our connectivity, TSPs are all very updated. We have the mobile density of 97.6. our internet penetration in Kerala, I think rural was more in the last 3 years. Rural was, I think, internet connection, out of the total internet connection, 51% was rural in Kerala. Am I remember correctly? I think 51 or 52% of the mobile internet connections in Kerala are rural, which was a surprising figure. So, whereas in other states, the rural is so poor. So Kerala citizens are very forward in getting digitally connected. And that internet number is, mobile internet connections are going at a very, very fast rate. Annual increase around 25%, about 20% growth is happening. So soon we will arrive at a situation where almost something like 60-70% of the people are on the net and they would be interacting with the government. On one side, when government is fully going on electronic way and citizens are connected to that thing, you will have a huge inflow and outflow happening on a daily basis, and all this will move through us because the government is a system to move through our STC. So the security of that is very important. And apart from that, there is a bigger issue happening is small fraud happening at the individual level. So a great amount of effort is required now to educate the public how safely to interact in the internet, how to carry out, how to enter internet and operate in a more secure fashion. That is a very, very important challenge in a country like India faces. Even Kerala, with this much of literacy and awareness, still in that person we have every other day police books cases of fraud happening. That is because of the lack of awareness. So we are now going ahead with a big program of digital literacy, which we will do with the school students, the student police cadet. We just started this now. They will go and sort of educate, create an awareness on security, plus they will educate how to actually get into internet safely, and also how the e-governance application they can make use of at their level. Now the my important theory, which I have been 30 years in my service, is the moment there is an intermediary, the moment there is an intermediary for a citizen to interact with government, whether it is a government official or whether it is a third party agency like Akshaya Center in Kerala, that is not the deliverance of citizen out of his problem. So when he is equipped and when he has a connection, a mobile connection, or whether he has a landline connection in his home, he should be able to do his citizens to business and citizens to government interaction, digital interaction by himself. So educating him to do that in a safe manner is a big challenge, which we have taken up. So we have the student police cadet as a pilot case. It is going on in Kerala. Once a pilot finds a success, which is in a very scientific manner we are doing it, we will take it to all Kerala. Maybe in a year's time, if that clicks, in a year's time, we will cover almost all the citizens who are in need of knowing this. Using each student will go and take 100, 200 people around his habitation and cover them. It's a very, very participatory process that we have decided. That is a very important thing in a country like India, to where involve people into this, people at large into this. Your technology and technical systems are different, but then people also have to know about this, they have to be made aware of this thing. That is the biggest thing that we want to do. Our e-governance approach is on a full swing, which goes on. So my sort of message to you is that one of the biggest challenges that we face is this. This would be the case throughout India, but need to really work at a larger level. Probably I feel that Kerala will act as a model on this to educate people at large on this. That is a very, very important thing. Then Kerala, the police is doing a cyber dome in Technopark, which will again be a very modern system where police will be able to track all sorts of fraud or something happening. That is a very great mission that we have. The police is already won that job, police department has already won that job. So these are a few things which we want to share what Kerala does as far as this subject is concerned. I request people who come from other states to sort of take this as a lesson. And I don't want to speak anything more than that you have well sort of alerted on this in the last 3 hours. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.